Hi, welcome to an Arduino lecture from RoboJax. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri. We're going to learn how we can use this K-type thermocouple with MAX6675 to control a load as a heater or cooler. So we can turn it on and off and keep the temperature in certain range, either as a cooler or as a heater. I'm using now bulb as a heater or cooler when the temperature reaches at 100 degrees. And the same way you can use it as a cooler. I will apply heat when the temperature reaches at 100 degrees Celsius. This heater will turn off. I'm applying heat here now. It turned off, and you can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. I've seen a lot of requests for this K-type thermocouple with MAX6675 to use it as heater control or cooler control with relay to turn on and off a load. And for that reason, I'm using this thermocouple and I'm using this bulb as a heater and cooler. How it works is for heater and cooler, we have two different start and stop. For heater, you need to have two temperature because you cannot have one number. For that reason, I put 80 and 100. I put them apart because the demonstration will be easy, but for real application, you might have something very closer. For example, this might be 80, the start, and the stop instead of 100, it might be 85. It's up to you. In the code, you can change it. So this is just a demonstration. So how it works for a heater, because we want a heat or certain temperature. Now, when the temperature reaches below 80 degrees Celsius, the heater control will turn on at this point, so that's why we call it 80. And our stop is set to be 100. Now the heater will turn on at the temperature, and the temperature will slowly increase. When it reaches 100 degrees, we don't want above that, it will turn off the heater. And it will not turn on again until it reaches 80. Because this is our range, it will stay at this temperature. When it goes below 80, it will turn on. And if you want to use it for the cooler, the same way we have it, but pay attention, the start was on this side. Now start is on this side. So when the temperature reaches 100 degrees, we don't want this to heat up. So the cooler or refrigerator will turn on at this temperature, for example, and it will reduce the temperature, slowly cool it down. When it reaches at the stop temperature, in this case, 80 degrees, the cooler will stop. Below this, the cooler is not used anyways, so it is off. The environment temperature will slowly increase. When it reaches back to 100 degrees, the cooler will start and again stop at 80. So we will always keep the liquid or whatever you have and within the certain temperature range. Hotter environment, you want to control a cooler with this thermocouple, or in a cooler environment, you want to use a heater to keep the temperature a certain level. So thermocouple is one of the option, because it can go, depending on the type, you can go up to 1000 degrees Celsius or even higher. I've separate video explaining this thermocouple sensor with MAX6675. I'm not going to explain all the detail and specification. The link for that video is below this video in the description. And also I have an introduction video for relay. We can use this type of module, or you can use this type of module, and I have separate video for those. The link for that is also below the video in the description. In this video, we are going directly on how to use it as a heater or cooler control. Now let me explain the wiring for the relay. We have VCC, we have ground, and we have input signal. From the left, this is connected using orange wire to 5 volts. The middle pin is ground, have been connected using red wire to the ground. And the last pin on this side is input. It has been connected to pin 8 here. For this K-type sensor to MAX6675, I've connected all these wires in order. As you can see it, from this side, I'm just inserting them in order here. I'm inserting them from pin 2 to pin 6, like that. They are in the same order. For this demonstration, I'm going to use this AC bulb. This is a plug that will be connected to wall outlet, and the light will be turned on. At the middle, at this point, I have disconnected the wire, one of the wire, the live wire here, and I've twisted them and prepared them. These two will be connected to the relay. Job of relay is to turn it on by connecting these two wire, turning on the light, and disconnecting it, turning it off. So this can be a bulb or a fan or any other load, the same way the relay will connect it and disconnect it. The two wire that I've shown you for the AC bulb is connected to these two terminals of this relay. And if you're using this relay, it will be connected exactly the same way to these two last terminals, in here and in here. And for this one, we have here the negative. This will be connected to ground. This is connected to 5 volts. And this pin is the signal or the input, which will be connected to pin 8. If you need the wiring diagram for this, it is available as part of my Arduino course at udemy.com. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects, all course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description. Now let me explain the code. First thing that you need is to download the library. I will provide you the zip file, and this is the address that you can get it. I will also provide you the link that you can get it from there as well. Once you download it as a zip file, click on sketch, include library, add.zip library, and then point it to where you have saved it. In my case, if I go to this PC, download tutorial, and if this was the zip, select it and click open. After that, you have to close your Arduino, all instances that you have, all of them, and then reopen it. If you go now on File, Example, and then Mac667 Library, there are two examples already. And this is a code that I've written based on that library. Because our relay needs 5 volts and the thermocouple needs 5 volts, so we are creating extra 5 volts. I have a separate video explaining how to use it, but here quickly we are defining a ground pin for our thermocouple, pin 2, VCC pin, which gives 5 volts to pin 3, and also we are defining clock pin, like the data output for these three. We are selecting pin 4, pin 5, pin 6. I've put them in order exactly the way they appear on the module, so you do not make mistake in the wiring. And here, this is from the library. We are creating a object. We call it thermocouple, and we pass these three pins here to the library, so library can use them. Then this portion is for relay. We define a pin for relay, relay 8. You can choose to type something else. And then we are defining relay on, relay off. If your relay is low trigger, this is the way you do. With low, it will turn on, and with high, it will turn off. If your relay is the opposite, it is high trigger, then change this to high and this to low. Otherwise, do not change it. Initial state is whatever you want. If the relay you want it to be turned on or the load to be turned on, change this to this relay on in here. Otherwise, it will keep it off like that. And then here, you can use the temperature either as Celsius, Fahrenheit, or Kelvin. Just set here 1, 2, or 3, depending on whichever you prefer. And you set your start temperature at 80, for example, and stop temperature at 100. Change that accordingly, and then control type here is the most important one. And if you want to use it as a heater, type here 1, otherwise type here 2. And inside the loop, if you want to do something else, this printing on this side is coming from here. Print temperature and then load control. So these three, this first one, this, and this must be here for the system to function, but for actual application, you perhaps you do not need it. In that case, just comment this out, and this will turn off this printing the temperature. But if you want to do something with the temperature, for example, the reading is 1,000 milliseconds, you can reduce it if you want to print it faster, or if you want to read faster. This is now 1,000 milliseconds or 1 second. And beside that, if you want to do something with temperature, you can use F and then temperature. This is a variable that is holding the temperature, and you can do something. For example, if temperature is greater than or equal 88 degrees, 89 degrees, 0.5, you can do something. And the condition is here between these two curly parentheses. Put your condition in here. You can turn on and off a relay or do something else if you want. Otherwise, the code will work fine. If you need full explanation of the code, it is available as part of my Arduino course at udemy.com, where I will explain everything. Now let me demonstrate the heater control. For heater control, we set this to 1. And in heater control, pay attention to the start, because we are starting at this point, because we want the temperature to be a certain level or higher. Now the temperature, when it reaches below 80 degrees, the heater will turn on. The heater will stay on until it reaches to the stop point, which we set in our code to be 100. Now at 100 degrees, it will stop, and it will stay off until it reaches 80 degrees. It will not be on here when it reaches that stop. Stop is just stopping it. When it reaches at 80, again, it will start, and the cycle will continue. Now the temperature is around 60 degrees, and as you can see, the heater is on. Because it is below this, the heater is on and it's trying to heat it up. Now we are using a heat gun to heat it up to reach this 100, to see if it turns off. And when it reaches back at 80, it will turn on. Now let me apply heat. Now at 100 degrees, the heater is now turned off, because we don't want any temperature above this, and it will cool down slowly until it reaches 80 degrees. Again, it will turn on. Now the heater is turned on, and the cycle will continue the same way. Now let me explain the cooler control. We have a start temperature of 100 degrees Celsius and stop temperature of 80. Initially, the temperature increases and reaches 100 degrees. The cooler will start, or it will turn on and running until it reaches 80 degrees, and it will stop, because below this we don't need it. Then when the temperature increases, this will not turn on here, because the starting point is at 100, so it allows it to reach 100, and when it reaches 100 degrees, then the cooler will start. So you can adjust this if you want to have a narrow control area for temperature. Currently it shows 62 degrees, and waiting when it reaches 100 degrees, it will turn on. Let me apply heat with this heat gun. So now it will reach at 100, and now this is our cooler. The cooler is turned on, and when the temperature reaches at 80, it will stop. Now you see it is 127 degrees, because it's a metal, and it, when I blow it, slowly it penetrated now inside, so that's why it's very hot. So at 80, it will turn off now. Now the relay is off and the load is off. And it will be off until the temperature reaches back to 100 to turn it on. Thank you for watching. This was how to use this thermocouple sensor as a heater or cooler control with relay and Arduino. If you like this video and learned something, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe. You pay attention to this. When the temperature reaches 100 degrees, this should turn off. So the temperature reaches at 100. And this is now turned off. This will stay off until this temperature is dropped back to 100 degrees. As you can see now, it is almost 136 degrees. So the temperature is slowly being reduced. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects. All course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description.